Thanks for reminding me.
All because of Marjorie's
mask. I grew up on a farm. What do you think? That's all I had.
You sat in your room and played Marjorie's mask and felt bad about yourself?
Yep, probably like Randall did, because he also grew up on a farm.
Here's the
Speaking
thing, though,
of Randall.
Randall is my waifu, so.
He is. He is an amazing person.
Randall is my homegirl.
But now we got triple homegirl. What up? Okay, in that case, I'm going to put Swag on my homegirl list.
There you go.
Yep. Just my BFFFL. But here we go, going right in. Now, Swag and Triple R, kind of a... They have now played each other quite a bit, actually.
Right.
It's been... they've been very involved. They've both been making it really far and ended up playing each other a lot. And this is winner's finals. Like, I think this is the setup that, yeah, has, like, been... most common of late,
right.
Honestly, is Randall and Swag in winners finals, and they're so even. And like, Swag has clutched out this set before. Not a player to mess with. He's so good.
Right.
His Mega Man just makes me cry every time. Tears of joy. Bye, girl. Bye.
Bye.
Bye, girl. Bye. Good to see you. Saying goodbye to St. Cloud. It was wonderful. Great tournament, everyone.
All of St. Cloud is my waifu.
Except Dane. Ha.
Well, Dane especially, but I love you all just as much. Dane is my wife. We got married like 3 months ago.
Back to the match. So we got... okay. So we got... It's literally dead even right now, Carbuck. This is crazy. Like, there we go, the ledge trump. Swag is so good with those. That's like one of his scariest options,
right.
I think, is the way he consistently ledge trumps, and his back air is so deadly.
It's just... It's always a very... For me, speaking personally, it's always a really nice thing to watch these two play because
yeah.
they both do a lot of really similar things.
Like, yeah.
Most notably with ledge trump and back air. Like, it's almost like I always think of it's going to come down to that. Who's going to grab the ledge
yep.
and you know, make the mistake?
Who's going to trump? Who's going to run for office 2016?
Do you know the record between Swag and Triple R?
You know what? I'm not familiar. Maybe Josh does. Okay, so Josh is going to look that up for us because, yeah, I want to know too. But Triple R, I thought an up throw would have killed, but maybe Triple R probably knows it.
It probably would have if the platform was there,
but
it wasn't.
Yep. So. Triple R knows, yeah. I wouldn't question. Nice forward smash. Okay, beautiful spacing.
Triple R knows everything.
He knows everything. Well, about Kirby? Probably.
I mean, he knows everything, period.
He probably has all the frame data, like, memorized.
I wouldn't be surprised.
Like, he could
that,
recite
actually.
It. Like a poem.
A beautiful, beautiful poem.
of Dreamland. Dreamland Theaters. Love it.
Swag,
right back at you.
Swag really doesn't have any room to breathe right now, and
yeah.
that's exactly what Triple R wants him to not have.
Yeah, this matchup is very much either Triple R is going in or Swag is spacing like a monster.
Right.
I feel like there's no in-between, right?
There really isn't.
Nice. Swag is so good at converting off of lemons. Like, lemons are good enough as it is, but he, like, grabs out of it, he fares out of it. He does, like, so much extra, like, technical work that I don't see Mega Mans usually do.
Right.
It's insane. That's it?
Yep.
Nice. Pummel twice. Pretty guaranteed. That was very smart to just ensure. Yeah, I just love the way he travels with lemons. He just gains so much momentum by doing that.
Mm-hmm.
And he crosses with it, too. That's what I really like about how he uses his neutral. Or his, I guess it's his jab, right?
Well, it's his jab,
his
neutral air,
yeah.
and his forward tilt as well.
Yeah, it's kind of like one of those things where he doesn't have as many moves, but that move is so good that he
yeah.
doesn't need more, so it kind of works.
And I was actually speaking about it with Dolph earlier. Since you have, like, three variations of the same move, but they're all basically the same move, they all stale differently, so you don't ever have to worry about it really staling, like, noticeably or anything like that.
Right. Okay. So it is, okay. So this is the sixth time they've seen each other in bracket. Right now it is 1-4, Triple R's favor. Yeah, that makes sense. I think the other time was a winner's final, but Triple R's been faring really well against him. Kind of, I think, in losers brackets and a couple other tournaments. Still though, like, Swag has proven himself over and over again.
He really has.
I mean, he won a tournament, right? Yeah,
I'm pretty sure he did. He won something.
He won, and then he's been consistently getting like top three, top four, which is just crazy good. Like, just against some of the players we have with the huge reps. Ooh, the leaf shield.
Leaves.
Ooh, so we're seeing this. Now Triple R's got a bit of a deficit. There we go. Here's the conversions. Nice work.
See, I still wonder why Randall doesn't copy Metal Blade, because I don't know what
I feel like it's
Kirby
really good.
Yeah, that's the thing. I don't know.
I agree.
I mean, obviously, Kirby can't use the follow-ups and combos that Mega Man does, because he doesn't have anything like it.
But it gives him a projectile.
Yeah, and it would just... It would give him something, you know, like another tool he could possibly use.
Maybe it's a matter of he just hasn't found a safe moment to do that, but that'd be... I don't know. Triple R's really good at getting it when he wants it, so I don't know. He copied my ability in our match, too. It was so much fun.
He copied Toad?
Yeah. He made it work. Like, it didn't... Like, it wasn't devastating, but... nice read. Okay. Triple R needed that really bad.
Right.
That's going to give him some nice momentum.
I think Swag would have been stuck either way. Even if he air dodged right there, he probably would have had too much lag, landed on the ground with air dodge lag, and gotten up smash anyways.
Yeah. Right, Triple R provided a really good trap there. That's something I've noticed he's been getting, he's always been good at, but he's getting even better at, is those, I don't know if they are technically frame traps, but he just covers options really well with, like, a certain way he sets something up. Like, the way he, for instance, sometimes down Bs offstage.
Right.
Both him and Prince Kirby are good at this, where they just create a situation where it's like, either you get bopped by it or you have to recover from far. And for characters that don't have good recoveries, that sucks, right?
Right.
So that's a really hard situation to be in. And we see Triple R kind of do that in other ways too, such as with the smash attack there. Mm-hmm. But we're going into game two. I'm not sure about the stage pick. I don't know. What do you think about Swag going here?
I think it would actually be a good stage for him because it does... It does give him, like, the space he wants. You know, he's got the platform, so he can set up Leaf Shield and Metal Blade if he needs to.
Yeah.
He can up air through the platforms, which I know he hasn't been doing much of because Kirby's so small. He can just duck under a lot of things, but these are all still things that would benefit him nonetheless.
True. Yep. Also, I think, adding on to that, I think Kirby also has a bit more, I would say, reliable kill power than Mega Man. So again, the increased boundaries would also help in this situation. I think it's also... Ooh, nice backer, though. I think the stage is also a bit bigger than, say, Smashville. So he has a bit more room to breathe and travel. Will that be... Oh, pummeled. When does up throw kill? I'm not quite sure on that.
I feel like it would kill by now.
I think at this point, yeah, with the little bit of rage he has. Definitely off the one of the platforms, though.
Right. I mean, the only way you manage to throw without a platform is if you were at, like, the very edge.
Swag doing an incredible job staying alive. Nice read, though, on the getup.
Good job by Randall. He does not care right now.
Randall just consistently proving why he is such a good player. Like, sometimes we have these breakouts like Swag or Shinjobi doing really well, and they deserve that. They've been doing really well, but, like, Triple R is just... Sometimes, at least lately, I feel like he's kind of been not forgotten about, but people don't pay attention to him as much, and I think they still should, because he is incredible.
He also is, and will forever be, the Kirby of Minnesota.
Oh, wow.
I wanted it. I wanted all of that.
And that's like, he's doing that against Swag. That triple Randall's feeling it. Ooh, that was questionable by Swag. He just kind of took that.
I'm sure Swag didn't think it would actually reach him.
Yeah, that's possible. Or sometimes it's just such a fake out that you just, like, blank out and don't know what to do. It happens. Oh, and there's the edge guard. Yeah, Randall is feeling himself right now. Just all this, like, risky stuff that's paying off that shouldn't. I feel like that's a sign.
Ooh.
Nice stuff by Swag, though.
Gets just barely clipped by that last hit of the Slash Claw.
And I'm so glad this is best of five, because these two, I love watching these two go out. They're both just incredible.
It's like art.
It is.
But
it's,
for your eyes.
It's art in motion.
Oh, it's good art. Excuse me.
Good art. So like Picasso.
No, Picasso is disgusting.
Okay, so like Salvador Dali.
Who?
This is Salvador Dali surrealism art history.
Dali. Oh, you mean Dali like the clone sheep. Back to the match.
Yeah. Speaking of which, back air. nice stuff by Triple R.
Yeah, I think Triple R, like, he has the momentum. And ooh, he had it most of
Nice hit jackpot by Spikes. So that's such a scary option. Like, if he grabs you and forward throws you behind the edge, that's an option he can do, and that, like, makes me disgusted.
Right.
Like, that makes me a little sick thinking about it. Nice stuff. Here we go.
I know Triple R does like to get people off stage as fast as possible and get them with repeated downers just because it is a very easy and reliable way to, mm-hmm. you know, just take someone's stock as soon as possible.
Totally.
It doesn't work often on players like Swag, though, because they know what to expect and they know how to get out of it.
Yeah, Triple R is showing up this match, though. He is just... I don't know what it is. He just changed something, and it's been working for him.
Right.
Still staying alive, has a healthy stock lead.
And at 130... That's it. Yep, that's it.
Good anti-air by Swag. Oh, he kind of lost it. There we go. Metal Blade shenanigans.
Oh, you.
You clown. Ow, you. Now, I love the way Swag uses... Oh!
Oh.
I love the way Swag uses Leaf Shield as that edgeguard option. Oh my gosh, it just like... I don't think Swag had a chance to get out of that. That was literally down air two throw or two grab. That's it. No, never mind. I spoke too soon.
He's going to have a tough time getting back, though.
Yeah, this is not a good situation still. Randall's all over it. This is it. No?
No. I think the next throw he would try would be the throw.
And he probably doesn't want to steal it either. Yeah. Smart. Man, Swag staying alive, though. That's it. Okay.
I don't think I've ever seen a forward air from
it's
a Kirby.
It's not common, but you know that... Really?
Really?
Oh, okay. That makes sense. Yeah, I think it's just a matter of, like, it's not a common, like, edgeguard option, but
yeah,
it does have that knockback.
I just don't see it a lot, period. Right. Unless it's, like, in a combo.
Yeah, I do notice other Kirby's go for it a lot. Triple R is just a lot more, he's a lot more...
I think he's a lot more decisive about it.
Decisive. I think he's also... And just, like, why he's just such a great player is he is very smart, because I think... Fair is one of Kirby's riskier moves as well,
right.
So he doesn't go for it. He opts for back air, which is much better at like space in terms of spacing and staying safe. Nice stuff.
Yeah, see, he just did a little thing with Metal Gear right there. You know, it was a small thing, but it was something.
Yeah, I don't know. I also just want to know what hat Kirby gets. I think he gets the helmet.
Yeah, I'm
like,
pretty sure
yeah.
he gets the helmet.
Kirby's so cute.
You right.
But yeah, okay, so Sway coming in a bit, looking a little rough for a little while, but he's coming back. There we go. That's the type of edgeguarding Sway I like to see. Beautiful. Ooh. Up there. I wasn't expecting that at all. That was so good. Spacing much better this match.
Great. Swag's doing a really good job of walling Triple R out.
Yep. And that's the game. I feel like it goes back and forth on that. Who gets their tactical positioning first? You know, does Swag keep him out or does Triple R get in?
Right.
Nice stuff. Good Z drop. Ooh. Oh, not going to get the... nice tech, Swag. The spike hitbox will get him. It's one of those rare moments where it... Yeah, that is situation and spike. Swag doing so good, trying to stay alive there, but just couldn't pull it off. That was a tough situation to be in.
Yeah, I know that final cutter can spike even at zero, and you know, while it is a light spike, it is a spike nonetheless.
Exactly. There it is. Oh, nice. Great avoidance by Swag.
Oh.
Ooh, and Swag coming back like, I have my own spike.
Right.
So honestly, if it's any testament, though, like, Animal Crossing characters' faces are just my reaction to...
Yeah.
They're just wide-eyed.
They don't know what to think, and neither do we.
That one, yep. Is that just random, or is there, like, a reason they do that? I don't know.
I have no idea.
The Animal Crossing faces. Okay. Ooh, Mike. Oh, jeez. Beautiful short hop right over that. I can't believe that worked, but it did. Alright, so something that... now Dribbler is taking this. What can I say? I mean, he...
I think
just so good at keeping the pressure. He's just so good at covering options.
I think he's being aggressive, but he's trying to be really careful about how he is aggressive.
Being patient and aggressive simultaneously. Is it?
Yep.
Yes, uses the platform. Oh, not quite.
Oh, jeez.
That was great DI by Swag and Midley,
yeah.
But I am still a little surprised with the platform.
He's got slight rage and is at 172, but he didn't die.
It does kill a lot later than I thought it did. The spike, why is that such a thing in this match? Oh, stresses me out just watching.
Right.
So Swag trying to fight for a way back on the stage and does get it, but here comes the back air.
I really liked how Triple R was just waiting.
Yeah.
Swag was up there and he
That's
was just
what it,
waiting.
That patient, he's just staring with Kirby's cold, dead eyes.
You're right.
Ooh, kind of a questionable Mega Man sure you can there. You know, up tilt. But Swag very capable. Kirby is at kill percent.
Whoa.
Nice read. There we go. He was ready for that. That was
right.
Beautiful.
He really wanted it the first time.
Mm-hmm.
Wanted it even more the second time, and he got it.
Yeah, exactly. The first time was just like a...
Call it a test run.
Yeah, he was like just, oh, like, does this move still work? Okay, I'm going to use it now.
Yeah,
like,
let's go.
Crazy. Here we go. Swag using that momentum really well right now, playing extremely safe. Here we go. Nice. Oh my god! Looking like Sheik over here with the triple fair. Oof. Remember when they kind of nerfed Mega Man and everyone's like, his fair's bad?
Yeah, because it did 4%.
Swag makes it work, and that just makes me really happy.
Right.
Oh, this is so close, Carbuncle. Oh! Twice. The reads. He just opened the dictionary on Dreamland. Just all over.
Randall didn't look very happy about that.
No, I think he knew that he was getting predictable, and that's why, admittedly, he was starting to develop a rolling habit in that game, and I think that he got it from the ledge a similar way.
Right.
Quite a bit, too. And that's the thing, it's just one of, like, those, it's a very risky move, but it's so powerful, and probably Mega Man's, or at least one of his earliest kill options, I want to say. Yeah, it's up there. Love you, Scorpio.
We love Scorpio,
we
too.
We miss you, bud. Hope you're enjoying this. Well, Josh doesn't.
But we're not talking about Josh right now, so that's fine.
It's fine.
It's fine.
Hi, Mr. Mayor.
Mr. Mayor is my boy.
To be fair, we are kind of mad at you all for not being here, so that's okay.
But we still love you. Anyways.
And going back to the match, this is best of five, so if Sway can pull off another game, we will see a game five. I think it's very possible.
Yeah.
And I kind of want it because it's so hype. I love these two fighting. Like,
and
it's fun.
I can most certainly see a game five happening because I know Swag is a person who really built on his momentum.
Yep. Now, he had a really, really well-played ending to that last game, and with two, like, up tilts taking Randall's last two stocks. Ooh. Nice stuff. Just walling it out, creating this, like, pillar of hitboxes. Crazy.
Right.
I also like the way he retreats with Lemons. There's a lot of really...
it's a really smart option.
Yeah, look at the way he just avoided all of that pressure from Triple R. That was crazy. Staying really even, though, not to count out Triple R. Nice. Yeah, it's weird. I want to see him use that projectile more. There it is. Randall,
third
again, getting predictable with his rolling. Gotta watch out for that. Give him the Kirby side. Not gonna quite do it.
Is it just me, or does Kirby does Kirby's smash attacks have like a really good amount of knockback to them?
Crazy amount. Like, Kirby's actually like all around, I think, has some of the better smash attacks because like all of them are really solid. He's a very like good character. I tell a lot of people like he's a great character to pick up and play if you're just starting the game,
right?
Because he's very straightforward. You don't really, they're all kind of similar. You don't have to think too much about the smash attacks and like his standard moves. Nice stuff, but mastering Kirby is something else, and that is what Triple R is here to show us today, is the mastery.
I'm surprised that short hop over Swag's forward smash worked. I thought Triple R would have been hit by that.
Yeah, he's been, Triple R's done that a couple times now. It's really interesting. It's like one of those weird things. Just kind of the way he can sometimes duck under the lemons. Not consistently, though. It, like, it's hard because Swag's so good about moving with them.
Right.
So it's not really an option he goes for too much. It's better to shield like he just did there. So, like, yeah, Triple R, I think he's getting, he was doing really well earlier, but I think he's losing his patience a little bit. He's been going for a...
Oh. Yikes.
Wow. I know it's Kirby, but I'm still a little surprised about that. Especially since it didn't seem like he was getting hit by all the hitboxes of the whirlwind, so it wasn't going to be as devastating, but... Yeah. It's one of those... It's like a silent but deadly move.
Yeah.
I feel like.
I think that's what bothers me about it the most, is that it doesn't actually, like, make you flinch or anything.
Yeah, but it kills you still.
Yeah.
Here we go. Now this is the Randall we know and love.
Yep. Swag is up a full stock, and he's got a healthy bit of extra credit on Triple R, so... He, you know, he could win this.
Yeah. Randall's just not... He needs to be a bit smarter again with his... Oh, nice duck.
Yep.
With his approaches. Mm-hmm. He's been doing a lot of, like, just kind of throwing aerials out and trying to, like, roll to gain advantage when I think he needs to be mixing it up a bit more.
Right.
Though, of course, he is a phenomenal player. I'm not going to tell him how to play, right?
Right.
He's in Winner's Finals for a reason. But that's what I'm observing.
Mm-hmm.
Nice. That's right. And, clean.
That's the fourth one, then.
If I had a dollar for every time I killed with enough tilt, I'd have $4. That's almost enough for a shake. Oh my god, like Perkins?
Perkins.
Spoilers.
Mm.
All right. Perkins, the same one. Surprise, we're not banned.
Yeah.
Surprise they didn't ban us like a stage right now.
We're okay, Diane.
We're okay. Where do you think Triple R is going to go?
I want to say...
He's thinking about it.
Yeah. Normally, I would say a place like Dreamland, but I think low ceilings are the last thing he wants right now.
Yeah, after losing that sock to an up air, and up tilts, for that matter.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Randall's really thinking about it. You don't see him, like, really, like, thinking... Or, like, visibly thinking too often. So this is... He's in a stressful situation, and for good reason. Like, Swag has carried a lot of momentum.
Lilat. This I can actually see being really good for Triple R.
Yeah, I don't think it's a bad option, considering that Swag did have bans, of course. Yeah, I think that's... It's not bad. I think it's one of his best options.
Right. Also knowing that...
That isn't like Smashville, you know?
Right. Also knowing that here, up tilt won't connect reliably the way Swag would want it to.
Exactly. That's a kicker. Yes, he can, like, kind of cancel it with a platform, but that's not nearly as good as what's been happening in this
set.
Because what matters is, like, the kill power it's been having. Also, Triple R seems to fare well against... With these, like, platform heights. They're greatly spaced for Kirby to do a lot of his devastating combos.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, nice back air. But man, yeah, game five, this is going a while.
Yep,
three-star best five slot.
His lemons can't be used effectively either because of the constantly moving stage.
Very smart. Yeah, so I'm a little surprised Spike did not ban this, to be honest.
Yeah, really. Randall made a fantastic choice by going here. This is great for Kirby. Well, at least in this matchup, I would say it's
I think,
for
yeah.
Kirby.
It's better. It's there we go.
Cool. Nice.
Nice stuff.
Yeah, no, I'm just thinking about it. Crash Bomb won't work reliably.
Yeah.
Metal Blade won't
Ooh,
work either.
That's a nice back air. I'm a little surprised to kill that early.
Yeah.
I don't know if the DI was optimal, but it was still very, very nicely spaced by Spike.
Right.
It's just his back air just scares the crap out of me. Like, it honestly does. I have nightmares about it.
I had one once.
Yeah.
Then I didn't.
The like, flashy, like, tri-colored sword of death. It's terrible. So, it's still a really even game, though. Spike trying to adapt to the stage. Doing a pretty decent job. Again, like, I feel like Lemons, he needs to, like, use the more aerially, if that's a word.
Yeah.
Just because of the tilting stage. But he's adapting pretty well.
Mm-hmm. For sure.
Nice fair. Nice bet. Oh, good conversion. That was a good reverse aerial rush, I think it's called.
Yep.
Oh, but... Oh, we come back. We live in. We live in.
I did not think he would be coming back from that.
I'm very surprised.
Yeah.
See, these two, it's just always like full of surprises. You never know what's going to happen. A lot of things like you wouldn't think would happen do. Okay. The leaf shield. That's interesting. I feel like in certain situations it can kind of help stuff certain hitboxes.
Right.
Because it collides. Ooh, nice backer, though. That was great patience by Randall. That's what he needs to be doing more and was doing in earlier games. Whoa, okay.
How did that... Oh.
I think Triple R was crossing him up. Maybe.
It's a possibility, I
Does
suppose.
It have, like, a weird, like, kind of somewhat suction effect? Like,
I don't think
know.
So. I mean,
I don't think so.
Yeah, I think he was, like, walking through him at the point when
yeah.
he hit.
Yeah, I think he was, like... basically in Mega Man, and then it, like crossing him up and was just close enough. Anyway, going into it though, and that's
See,
what I mean.
Yep.
Yeah, you were very right, Carbuncle, right there, and Triple R being smart, understanding that's like what's been getting Swag the wins, so he does something about it with his counter pick.
Oh, he tried for it again, but
yeah, it's not as reliable.
Yep.
So people wanting to learn how to fight Mega Man, take notes. Spike, looking at a bit of a deficit, it's not unwinnable by any means, but he's got some ground to cover. Nice throw. He needs this edge guard. Ooh!
Mega Man's up throw can kill, can't it? No.
His
no,
back throw kills, yep. I believe. Yeah, his up throw can kill at instant.
Okay.
5% like a lot of characters. But it's Kirby at one. Yeah, that's not a very reliable... option at all for killing. Ooh, there it is. Beautiful trade by Randall. Very
yep.
smart to just be aggressive in that moment. Good stuff. And great stuff by Swag for like carrying that momentum, almost coming back from a 2-0 and winning it.
Right.
So, like, props to him. And he's still in it. That was only winner's finals. We have not seen the last of these players. Look at that, Randall. Walking away. Like a movie, like an action movie. I just want some explosions.
This is a sad movie.
With, ooh, sad. Mm.